Hello, Moonshiners, and welcome to the grand finale episode of the Moonshine Cafe online open mic. Thanks for coming, and thanks for sending in your videos. I can't believe we've managed to get to episode 24 of a season that I was hoping was going to be, I don't know, three or four episodes before we were back at the Moonshine enjoying ourselves and singing up a storm. But man, oh man, this COVID thing just keeps on trucking. And, well, we have no idea whether it's going to mean shutdowns again in the future or what have you, but it is great to be able to wrap up our this amazing adventure of online shows, and fingers crossed we can continue to do the in-person open mic, which has been going great back at the Moonshine, you know, as best we can with all the safety precautions in place. So, if things go bad, obviously, there's a chance that we will start up a season two of the online open mic, but I don't know. Although there's a lot about it that I really enjoyed, I would love for us to continue just to be able to do normal life. In the meantime, we're going to have a good time tonight. There are just an incredible array of videos that have poured in from regulars and occasionals, and it's great to have everybody be a part of this. So stick around, enjoy the show, and yeah, we're going to have a good time, everybody. Cheers.
The race was coming to an end. Somebody told me the finish line was near. Somebody told me you'd better hold on to your friend. Somebody told me the facts are clear. Well, I don't know about it. I don't know everything that's going on. I don't know about it, but I know there's always another dawn. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not the end of the world. Somebody told me the climate hammer's coming down. Somebody told me it's economic doom. Somebody told me pandemic's gonna kill us all. Somebody told me disaster looms. Well, I don't know about it. I don't know everything that's going on. Oh, I don't know about it, but I know always another dawn. If we share joy, if we find peace, if we choose hope, we can learn to cope. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not of the world. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world as we know it. No, it's not the end of the world. And I feel fine.
Thank you. these old eyes remember when we were young and free, and how you looked when we met to lock eyes with me. An image burned deep inside my memories, and though I can't see you with these old eyes, I turn in and I see you. These old eyes remember well when we were wed, and how yours gleamed in the light, the smile that spread across your face as we danced, and how you blushed red when we said goodnight to all those folks and turned to bed. Oh, these old eyes have no regrets. These old eyes have no regrets. Recall when these old eyes grew wide then mild, the day that you delivered us our only child. Oh, when I first looked into her face, well, I swear she smiled. Oh, how it warmed my heart to see her eyes so bright and wild. Oh, these old eyes have no regrets. These old eyes have no regrets. Remember when you passed away, I looked into your eyes to see there would be no more memories. But as I look back across the years, the winds of time dry up my tears, and all the things these old eyes have seen, they come back to me clear and clean. Oh, these old eyes have no regrets. The things they've seen in grief, in death, so many other eyes have seen so much less. So these old eyes have no regrets. These old eyes have no regrets.
Thank you. doesn't mean it's right. It couldn't be further from the truth. It takes all kinds of people to put yourself at ease. It's just water under the bridge. We fought for nothing, for your right to say, at least I'll have a chance.
Thank you. I want to thank John, and I want to thank especially Neil for stimulating us and driving us and bringing us along all these last 6 months. Thanks, awesome job.
Here morning rain with a dollar in my hand and an ache in my heart and my pockets full of sand. I'm a long way from home and I miss my loved ones so. Best be on my way. In the early morning rain, my old room window number 9, 707 set to go. But I'm stuck here on the ground where the cold wind blows. And the liquor tastes good, and the women are fast. There she goes, my friends. She be rolling out at last. Angels roar, silver bird up on high. She's away and westward bound, high above the clouds she'll fly. Where the morning rains don't fall and the sun always shines, she be flying over my home in about 3 hours' time. This old airport's got me down. It's no earthly use to me. I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. You can't hop a jet plane like you can a freight train. So I best be on my way near the morning rain.
Pretty lady, she'll never put you down. You'll big brown eyes makes you want to die. She's just a bluegrass lady that lives from town to town. Don't know if she'll ever settle down. And she's baking fresh hot brownies, everyone gets high. She's got the kind of big brown eyes makes you wanna die. She's just a bluegrass lady, lives from town to town. Don't know if she'll ever settle down. Well, the lady is a mystery, and with the magic eyes, makes you want to love her, gives you through her disguise. Searching for the answers to learn what life's about. Should she ever find it, I'd be the first to shout. And she's baking fresh hot brownies, everyone gets high. She's got the kind of big brown eyes makes you wanna die. She's just a bluegrass lady. She's just a bluegrass lady, lives from town to town. Don't know if she'll ever settle down.
Hi, Moonshine family. We chose this song because we feel that the title describes the year 2020 absolutely perfectly.
We have both faced a lot of challenges this year, not to mention the entire world facing the COVID isolation.
But Neil's virtual open mic at the Moonshine has provided such a great oasis for us all. This is Beautiful Disaster.
He drowns in his dreams, an exquisite extreme, I know. He's as damned as he seems, more heaven than a heart could hold. And if I try to say, Lord, it just ain't right. Oh, and I don't know what he's after, but he's so beautiful, such a beautiful disaster. And if I could hold on through the tears and the, oh, would it be beautiful, just a beautiful disaster. His magic and myth, the strongest what I believe. A tragedy with more damage than a soul should see. And do I try to change him? So hard not to blame him. Hold on tight, baby, hold on tight. Oh, when I don't know what he's after, but he's so beautiful, such a beautiful disaster. And if I could hold on through the tears and the laughter, oh, would it be beautiful, just a beautiful disaster. I know you're falling. to the touch. But frayed at the ends, he breaks. He's never enough. Still is more than I can take. Oh, when I don't know. Disaster. He's beautiful. Lord, he's so beautiful. He's beautiful.
Hey there, gang. So it feels like a million years ago that way back in the spring, I did a little video that showed you a little glimpse into my veggie garden. And so it's time to give you a little bit of an update on what's going on in my garden. Some successes, some failures, but that's okay. It's part of the fun. We've had so many tomatoes this year, it's unreal. And so the whole middle of the garden has just completely collapsed on itself. There was a path in the middle of this that you can't even see anymore. There's just tons of tomatoes in here. I've been freezing them and turning them into soup and sauce and all kinds of stuff. You can see we've got the bright yellow and these little red ones over here. And then back against the fence, these are called purple prints. Right here is bush bean that produced some beautiful purple colored beans. And then we've got these other bean plants that, oh, there's the base of it here. And we've got this forsythia beside the patch here, and the vine beans just climbed right up the forsythia way high there. Just hanging right at the top, they're delicious. Whoa, check them out. Now down here in front of the tomato patch, I planted a whole bunch of peppers. I had a lot of trouble with peppers in previous years. They produced peppers that were like, you know, the size of my thumb. And these are actually looking like real peppers. We picked a bunch of them while they were green and then sort of realized that if you wait a little while longer, they do turn red. So how about that? Let's see, down the other end of the yard, this little patch of garden over here is looking beautifully filled with garlic chives. All these flowers will produce an absolute ton of seeds, so if anybody wants some garlic chive seeds, let me know and I'll pass them along. The little patch that I had in front here for growing onions, well, it really just became overgrown. The earth is terrible. Look at the cracks in the soil here. And this was with regular watering. I've got these onions here, and they are pretty tiny. What happened was the bunnies came along and they ate off all the tops. So the rest of this patch I planted with kale. Has grown up rather nicely. Now over on my lovely hillside here, we had a few things planted, but as you can see, the strawberries just absolutely took over this entire hillside. And well, wild strawberries are pretty tasty, so we decided not to get rid of them all. Part of the problem with the hillside garden is this honey locust tree, which we planted some years ago to be a bit of shade, but now it has thrown so much shade that very little grows here anymore. So, lesson learned on the garden, this end of the yard, way more prolific for growing things than the other end of the yard with the big tree that's throwing all the shade over everything. Who would have guessed that sun makes plants grow? Anyways, hope you enjoyed the garden tour. Cheers, everyone. Now, back to the show.
safely spat on your grave. It's a parade. Just a slave, they spat on your grave. You went fighting against the fascist regime, and yet freedom at home, only a dream.
Thank you. guess that I was destined to live my life alone. Many of my relatives have their happy homes. Never was a man to fit in. I'm always on the outside looking in.
Gary and Loretta, finally back together. Welcome back, Loretta.
Oh, thank you.
Got a new one for you. 1, 2, 3. Back Roads. Country song. Pull down my cap. Put her in gear. Gave her some gas, man. Rolled out of here. Taking a ride back to where I belong. Away from the city. All of its farms on the back roads. The stars really shine on the back roads. You lose track of time on the back roads. A ghost in the breeze on the back roads. You can finally be on the back roads. 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 Let's hit it right. Watch out for that deer.
Uh-oh.
Moose up ahead.
Ooh, dangerous.
I could do with a moose head right now.
Couldn't we all?
Should've left sooner, something holding me back. You know how it goes, Loretta. Sometimes you get off track. Better late than never to make your way back. So many people getting caught in the trap. Took me some time before I realized I was out of my head, living a lie. Gotta get back to my roots, back in my boots. Back to the country for what I was bred. On the back roads, the fish always bite. On the back roads, apples so ripe. On the back roads, you get all you need. On the back roads, so open and free. On the back roads, 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 on the back roads. Let's finish her horizon. Get back, JoJo.
I'm back.
I'd like to play one of my favorite hip songs for you. This one's called Wheat Kings. And I'd like to say thanks to Gord Downey and the Tragically Hip for bringing us so many great songs and drawing everyone's attention to some of the injustices around the world. Sundown in the Paris of the prairies. Wheat kings of all their treasures buried. All you hear are the rusty breezes pushing around the Well, thank Jesus. In his Ippolita, he sees a killer's face. Maybe it's just someone standing in the killer's place. 20 years for nothing, well, that's nothing new besides. No one's interested in something he didn't do. Wait, kings and pretty things. Let's just see what the morning brings. Yeah. Dreamy dreams where the high school is dead and stark. It's a museum where all locked up in after dark. Where the walls are lined all yellow, gray and sinister. Hung with pictures of our parents, prime ministers. Wait, kings and pretty things. Just see what the morning brings, yeah. Late breaking story on the CBC. A nation whispers, we always knew that he'd go free. And they add you can't be fond of living in the past, because if you are, then there's no way that you're gonna last. Wait, kings and pretty things. Let's just see what the morning brings, yeah. Wait, kings and pretty things. Well, that's what tomorrow brings. Cheers, guys.
She makes his coffee. She makes his bed. She does the laundry. She keeps him fed. When she was 21, she wore her mother's lace. She said forever, with a smile upon her face. She does the carpool, she PTAs. Doctors and dentists, she drives all day. When she was 29, she delivered number 3. And every Christmas card showed a perfect family. Everything runs right on time. Years of practice and design. Spit and polish till it shines. He thinks he'll keep her. Everything is so benign. Safest place you'll ever find. God forbid you change your mind. He thinks he'll keep her. All right. Shee-dee-dee-dee-dee. She packs his suitcase. She sits and waits with no expression upon her face. When she was 36, she met him at their door. She said, I'm sorry, I don't love you anymore. Everything runs right on time. Years of practice and design. Spit and polish till it shines. He thinks he'll keep her. Everything is so benign. Safest place you'll ever find. God forbid you change your mind. He thinks he'll keep her. La 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 la. Da 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 da. 15 years she had a job, not one raise in pay. Now she's at the grocery store at minimum wage. But everything runs right on time. Years of practice and design. Spit and polish till it shines. He thinks he'll keep her. Everything is so benign. Safest place you'll ever find. That's until you change your mind. He thinks he'll keep her. La 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 la. Da 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 da.
The song was originally written by P.F. Sloan in around 1961. It was made a huge hit. 65? Okay, thank you. It was made a huge hit by Roger McGuinn. And in the 80s, he changed the words.
McGuinn and McGuire are still trying to catch on fire. And they'll let you know where that's at.
Right, P.F. Sloan in 1965.
Hello. Made,
yes, all right. At any rate, point is that he changed the words a little bit in the 80s to make it relevant, so I felt I could change the words a little bit today.
And you did a good job. Yep. Everybody's going to find out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is one of my favorite covers that I often do. It's by a band called Lifehouse. Seemed appropriate.
I can't be losing sleep over this. No, I can't. Now I cannot stop pacing. Give me a few hours, I have this all sorted out. My mind will just stop racing. Cause I cannot stand still. Can't be this uncertain. This cannot be happening. This is over my head, but underneath my feet. But by tomorrow morning I'll have this thing beat. And everything will be back to the way that it was. I wish that it was just that easy. I'm waiting for tonight. Still waiting for tomorrow. And I'm somewhere in between. What is real and just a dream? Catch me if I fall out of what I fell in. Don't be surprised if I collapse down at your feet again. Don't want to run away from this. I know that I just don't need this. Cause I cannot stand still. Can't be this unsteady. This cannot be happening. Cause I'm waiting for tonight. Still waiting for tomorrow. And I'm somewhere in between. What is real and just a dream? What is real and just a dream? What is real and just a dream?
Thanks very much. Stay safe, everybody.
Well, Hi, everyone. I'm Marc Punga. I'd like to congratulate Neil MacNaughton for the fabulous 24 virtual shows that he's produced. Well done, Neil. The Moonshine community is grateful for your help in getting us through these dark days of COVID isolation. And I'd also like to thank all of you for the warm reception you've always given myself and Windsor friends Joe Del Duca, Dave Clarke, and Rick Farr anytime we've appeared on the virtual stage of the Moonshine Cafe. John and Jane, this Neil Young song's for you.
Thank you.
Hey gang, as you all know, COVID has hit the music world very hard, including our beloved Moonshine Cafe. Now, I've been going to the Moonshine since before it was even the Moonshine. Back when John and James were running open mics over at the Piccadilly. And it's been an amazing ride, and, well, I'd sure hate to see it all come to an end because of a viral infection and pandemic. It's so weird. It's so sci-fi. Anyway, it is real life. It's really happening. So the best we can do is try to figure out our way through it. And one of those ways is supporting the Moonshine through this amazing GoFundMe campaign that they've got going with Ron Mueller and Paul Rooney putting it together. When they first approached me and mentioned that this was going to be going on, I was like, $75,000? Are you kidding me? But like, we're well over $40,000 now, and I hope we're on our way to reaching the goal. I'm sure that many of you have already donated. If you haven't, please do if you can, and please pass on the message and forward it to your friends and family and let them know how much the Moonshine means to you, and hopefully we'll get through this. Cheers, everyone. Now back to the show.
Thank you.
I've been blessed in this life. There was an emptiness in me. I was imprisoned by the power of gold. With one honest touch, you set me free. Let the world stop turning. Let the sun stop burning. Let them tell me love's not worth going through. If it all falls apart, I will know deep in my heart the only dream that mattered had come true. In this life, I was loved by you. For every mountain I have climbed, every raging river crossed, you were the treasure that I longed to find. Without your love, I would be lost. Let the world stop turning. Let the sun stop burning. Let them tell me love's not worth going through. If it all falls apart, I will know deep in my heart the only dream that mattered had come true. In this life, I was loved by you. In this life, I was loved.
All right, I'm gonna get it this time. I'm a first world prick, I'm not proud of it, but I still reap the benefits through all of this shit. I got a good job, great family as well, boyfriends feel swell, but I complain on the regular. Instagram tells me to shut the fuck up. I am far too privileged to be feeling the stupid. The world's always been righteous, but I lived in a bubble through all of it. Yeah, I'm a first world prick, you're a first world prick. We complain cause we are feeling it, but guess what? Life sucks. Tough enough, get a job. This song is about injustices and how I'm not allowed to complain about them, because I'm not visually in the thick of it. Whatever, I'll spin it so I win. About good old empathy, that's the thing that makes us feel things. Like when I walk into a room, a doomy, gloomy room, and I start feeling all doomy, gloomy too. And it's cause of neurological factors that others produce, or philosophical, psychological factors too. Factors too. Like not knowing how to not walk a mile in someone else's shoes. Let's hear for boundaries. I don't got none of these. I don't got none of these. See the world we live in, filters and bullshit. Empathy's not worth it. That's my humble opinion. Cause with something as great as empathy, you'll end up feeling like shit way too frequently. And frankly, this frequency we see is cause we're freaking taught to only value feeling happy, and that's a concept called toxic positivity. Toxic positivity, which ironically prevents me from feeling happy. Guilt free. I gotta sit with the ugly. I gotta honor my story. I gotta see and I gotta be happy. I got to learn boundaries. I got to stop crying. I got to make more money. I got to keep my room clean. Got to have a baby. Got to shave my legs. I got to be healthy on one last note. Stop putting filters on your face. You're far too pretty already. And just cause a meme said you're doing it wrong, doesn't mean you're doing it wrong. You're probably not doing it wrong. Oh, and just cause a meme says you're doing it right, doesn't mean you're doing it right. You're probably not doing it right. You're probably not doing it right. Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Take him just because you can. I want to give a big thank you to Neil MacNaughton and John from the Moonshine Cafe for hosting these virtual open mics. The song I want to share with you guys is a song that is releasing October 9th, and it's called Dance Around It. We don't gotta dance around it. Maybe it's the way that you're shining in the neon light. Been on all night, but there's something in the way you've been looking at me that we both can't deny. It just not, there's something buzz between us and a wound and a closed time. We found love dancing in the dark, cause the kind of buzz you can't find at the bar. We can ditch this floor, wanna get to know every part of who you are. Looking for this feeling, but found it. We don't gotta dance around it. We don't gotta dance around it. Maybe there's a reason that we both wound up here. Probably it's just the thought of a nice cold beer. But it became something that ain't just gonna disappear. That was my newest song called Dance Around It. Be sure to stream it in all streaming platforms and look me up on Facebook and Instagram at Haley Verrill Music. Thank you.
it's an honor and a privilege to take part in this grand finale of the Tuesday Video Online Open Mic Moonshine Night, curated by our genial host, Neil MacNaughton, who's done an amazing job over the past 6-7 months throwing these together. I know I've had a ton of fun. I haven't been as active recently. I think I've kind of hit the COVID wall. This whole isolation thing's been sapping my motivation, my desire to play, my creativity, all that stuff. So, but I knew I wanted to be a part of this final one, so I got my ass in gear and I pulled up my looping station just to start playing around, looking for some mojo, some inspiration. So I added a little groove. I won't take you through the layering of that through the looper, but I already stored it, so it starts like this. Anyway, this is an appropriate title because it's called Shine. Live under the hydro towers, listening to them singing in the park. While too tight and all the radios are glowing in the dark. Mothers lie down in the daytime, dream about Hollywood. I know that they get there if they could. Sit around cross-legged on the floor, living rooms, electric TVs, light bulbs, I am cancer to the core. Out in our backyards waiting for women and flying saucers. Stars and power lines. It's just a matter of time before we get to shine. It's not a question of when, who does the crime? Question of when, who does the crime?
Shiners, that is it. That is the show. That is the series. 24 episodes. It's an achievement. It really, really is. And I can't thank you enough for the support and for sending in your videos week after week. You know, sure, I put a lot of effort into this, and you know, I do these silly little in-between bits about garlic mustard and I don't know how to make bannock and stuff like that. And it's been a blast, but really it is have been all about you guys. You know, each week you've been sending in this material that is super, you know, just really entertaining. And there'd be no show without it. You know, you guys are producing the content, so it is really, it's your show, and you've done amazing things with it. So thank you so much for participating. And I hope to see you on the stage at the Moonshine Cafe, if you can make it down. Yeah, I know times are tough and times are difficult, but we are going to get through it. We're going to follow all the safety precautions we can. And if we have to shut down again, then we'll do that and maybe even bring this show back for a little bit. But fingers crossed, you know, with that campaign going to raise some funds to help get the Moonshine through all the difficult spots. I'm looking forward to seeing your happy smiling faces on the Moonshine stage and hearing your songs there once again. So, to take us out, we've got Ron Bomber lined up, and from a show not too long ago, so not a deep dive into the archives or anything like that, but he's got a nice long song to take us out while we watch credits. I've got credits lined up. Yes, all of you who have participated over the last 24 episodes, hope I've got everybody listed in the credits. So play Spot the Name and enjoy. And see y'all again soon, everybody. Bye!
Melvinson on the bass guitar.
Another bill, a kind of piece of rock. He's gonna open wide the line of his.